The first and probably the most important page of the entire VertiPaq analyzer tool is the first page. The first page contains information about tables and columns, and it contains all the relevant information in a single pivot table. Let's start looking at the detail. You see that we have all the tables listed here, and for each table we have this part, which is the most relevant one. Cardinality represents the number of rows in the table, whereas table size is the size in bytes of the table. And you can easily spot from here that sales is the largest table of the entire model. Out of a model which is 176 megabytes, 171 is used by only the sales table. So when you focus on optimizing a model, you know that most of your effort will be on the largest table, because there is where you can get the best benefit by reducing the model size. So we have cardinality, we have table size, and near the bottom we also have another important piece of information, which is the database size percentage. This is basically the division of table size by the total table size. So this is telling me that 96.97% of the total database size is used only by the sales table. Looking at the table level gives you an information about what are the most important tables you need to work with. Then you need to drill down at the column level in order to find more information. Let's focus on sales, which is the largest table. And if we expand sales, you see that we have all the columns of sales available to inspect. Cardinality at the column level does no longer represent the number of rows. Instead, it is the cardinality of the column, the number of distinct values of the column. The larger the number of distinct values, the more problem a column might create us. So cardinality tells us that there is only one value for currency key, there are 1100 values for delivery date, and 1.6 million values for the order number. We also have the column total size, the data size, dictionary size, and column hierarchy size. The total size is basically the sum of data size plus dictionary size plus column hierarchy size. Depending on the compression that the engine decided to use column by column, you will have a larger size for the data size or for the dictionary size, because the dictionary is useful for hash encoding. It contains the dictionary of the column, whereas the data size is the size of individual segments. They depend basically on the kind of compression and the number of rows which are stored in your model. So you can inspect the size column by column, and then you can also get more information. You have column by column the kind of encoding. Most of these columns have been compressed using hash encoding, but if we look, for example, in customer has the birth date for which the engine decided to use value encoding. Then you have the size of user hierarchies, the size of relationship, and the number of referential integrity violation, which is the number of times that there is a value that references a value in the target table that does not exist, referential integrity violation. We have the percentage, as we have already discussed, and finally we have the number of segments, the number of partitions, and the number of columns. The number of segments depend on the size of the table. Here we are using a Power BI, therefore each segment is 1 million rows, and sales is the only table that contains multiple segments in one single partition. The number of partitions is present, of course, in a much larger model where you have multiple partitions, and it tells you how many partitions are present for that table. The number of columns basically tells you how many columns are there. Just by inspecting this first page, you already have a very good overview of the entire model, so you know where to search for columns that use a lot of space and are potentially slow to scan.